Hello and welcome everyone. So in this particular webinar we are going to talk about the PM2, which is Node.js process manager to keep your application up and running in the different environment. So PM2 is a process manager, and you will get a more introduction about PM2 when we go along. So how to first of all get started with the PM2 is you just need to install it globally on your system, and you can also install it locally, so you can run the PM2 commands from your package.json. So PM2 is a process manager which keeps which makes your application up and running. So there are different cases where your application can crash, like unhandled rejection, or there are some runtime error or some exceptions occurred in some API. In that case, your applications might terminate if you are not using PM2. But if you are using PM2, then PM2 will restart the applications and you will be able to see the application up and running again. So PM2 has a basic command like PM2 list, which will give you the list of instances currently you are having. So PM2 info, the basic commands, where you can get the information about the PM2, PM2 info, PM2 list, and PM2 info 2. Let's do it. Instance ID is 2, right? So it will give you the instance information, that what the application you are running. Okay, all these information. Similarly, PM2 info 3, PM2 list is giving you this information. So there is a version mismatch, so I will just do a PM2 update. So it is saving your current PM2 instance and updating the local instance of PM2. Then it will restart both the PM2 instance. So before understanding PM2 in depth, because PM2 is providing a lot of different features. So like you have seen about the forever.js is there, or running the Node.js process in the background, there are other tools also. But PM2 is most popular because PM2 is providing other features also, where you can spin up your multiple applications onto the different instances of the PM2. PM2 is providing the load balancing. You can run the multiple applications onto the different port on different PM2 instances. All these things PM2 is providing. So to enter into depth that what PM2 is providing, you can just talk about the clustering in the Node.js process. So earlier, whenever we need to run the multiple process, what we used to create, a child. So we used to use the cluster module in the of the Node.js, and we used to create a child thread and used to run another application onto that. But now that same kind of a clustering is being done with the PM2. So this is what we used to do. We used to consume, or we used to require the cluster module, and that cluster module is checking if it is a master. Otherwise, we used to fork based on number of CPUs we have in the application. So in the PM2 way, you don't need to do anything. So PM2 start app instance. So like app.js is your server file, and you wanted to create a 4 different instance of this application. What you will do, PM2 start app.js. This is the number of instances, like you are creating 4 different instances for this application. Similarly, so now if you do this, you will be able to see the 4 different instances here, which are online on the cluster module. So to keep your applications up and running, like we can run all these different command. PM2 monitor, which is an important command, which keeps track of your current instances. Right now we are not doing any logs, so that's why no logs are coming here. So this is a PM2 list, and you can just do a PM2 restart all. So what it will do, it will restart each and both the instances. So you can create a multiple instances. So here we are just doing it from the command line. We are running the basic command, PM2 start app.js instance 4. Similarly, you can define, or you can decide how many number of instances you need. And you can also decide to scale your application at the runtime, like PM2Scale App+3. So whenever the huge traffic is coming, your application will scale up to 3 more instances. And you can see now I have 7 instances here, right? PM2Scale App 2, so it will increase 2 more instances. So the only thing which we always wanted, that zero downtime whenever we run the application in the production. So PM2 is providing that feature, PM2 reload or application name. So what this feature is enabling is, whenever your application is running in production, there are 3 different instances or 3 different servers are running. So whenever you do PM2 reload, it will actually stop one at a time. So it is not stopping all the 3 instances running at a single instance. It will do one by one. So you will be able to achieve the zero downtime with the help of PM2 reload. So it is actually, we can all either use a graceful reload feature, or either we can just use the PM2 reload, because the graceful reload is actually, it is sending the kill or shutdown signal one by one, and it is closing the exiting the event and starting again. Okay, so this is one of the good blog which you can look for to understand how the PM2 works. We can play around with the PM2 commands, like PM2 list. Here you can do a PM2 delete. If you wanted to delete 0 instance, it will remove the 0th one. It will remove the 1st instance. Now PM2 list, we have removed all the instances. Okay. Now if you wanted to create PM2 start app.js -i 6, right? So what it will do? It is going to create 6 different instances of your single application in the cluster module, right? So you can see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can just check the PM2 logs, what actually happened. So you can see a few things are breaking here. It is able to up, this is up and running. This is up and running. So I'm not interested in running all. PM2 delete all. So it will wipe out each and every instance. Okay. I wanted to create only 2 instances here. One instance is fine. So you can see my one instance is up and running. Okay, let me just check this. What is the problem with this? Okay. Let me just check where I'm running it. So it is having, so this is my app.js which I'm trying to require. Okay, so I will just hit node app.js to see if things are working. Okay, nvm I have. So I should be having app.js in the current folder. So node app.js. Why my node command is not being identified? Okay. So let me switch to the NVM version. Okay, now what I will do, PM2 start app.js, this is my file, minus instance. I'm running a single instance. You can see I'm able to see one instance up and running, and PM2 monitor, where you can just monitor this particular process. Okay. Now another important thing is we are actually doing the clustering with the PM2, right? How to set up all these things with a single configurations, right? If you have a multiple applications, so what in the real time what you will do, PM2 stop this instance, like PM2 stop app, it will stop it, sorry, PM2, and then what you will do, you will restart it. Whenever you have a new code, you will just restart it and it will up and running. But when you have multiple applications, then on the pipeline you cannot do this, right? So you need to have some kind of a configuration using which PM to read that configuration, it will start spinning up your application. So we can create an ecosystem config. Ecosystem config will have these all different parameters, that which is the script we are running, how many instances we are going to run. Here I have provided the instance 2, environment variable if there is any, and there are some timeout to kill timeout and lesion timeout you can pass. So this is actually the PM2 reload feature. PM2 reload requires some kind of a JSON file, the environment file, because PM2 it is actually going to reload. So it need all the environment that where to which where your application server is residing, in which particular file, either it is app.js, server.js, index.js. So PM2 reload is actually something like this: PM2 start to reload. If there are no existing instances running, then it will start, otherwise it will reload. Okay, so PM2 start and reload is an important feature. NPM run deploy. So what it is doing, it is actually application started, already not running, so it is going to start API server app. This named of app was not available, so it is starting that application for the first time, and it is going to create two instances for that application. So we are getting these deployment with the help of ecosystem config.js file. So we call it as a process.json also, like PM to deploy your configuration file and your environment. You can pass something like this. In your configuration file can be a .json file, like ecosystem config.js file. This is what you are going to maintain. And in this ecosystem file, you can provide multiple applications in an array. These are the different apps we are going to have. So you can create an ecosystem file, default ecosystem file, using this command. It will give you the empty skeleton ecosystem file, where you can define your individual app. So the first app, script is app.js and node environment is production. Second app is web, and the file name to start the server is web.js. Similarly, to deploy on the production environment, it is going to set all these variables. To deploy on the dev environment, it is going to set all these parameters. Okay, so we are just fine to write the ecosystem file in the apps array only, like something like this. So I just have the apps array where I have defined my all these different apps. Right now I have only single app, so I specified the app name, script and instances. That is fine, and you can just provide all these different kind of timeouts. Okay, so I can see that there are two instances are already running, so you can delete the app. I have these two instances there. Okay, so PM2 start ecosystem config.js, this is what it will do. It will launch all the services inside this, right? But to deploy, you always need to use this command, start or deploy. It should be somewhere like PM2 deploy, start and deploy. So you can see I'm using start or reload, ecosystem config.js, and update environment. So what this flag will do, whenever you start the PM2 process again, it will get the new config from the ecosystem config.js. It will get the new environment variable if you are changing. Okay, now next thing which I will talk about is the monitoring of Node.js process. That can be done with the help of key metrics or New Relic. So key metrics is one of the new tool which is out there in the market and available for the free subscription also. So what you need to do, this is a key metrics. Key metrics is providing you to monitor the PM2 statics. PM2 is, what is PM2? Process manager, which is running your Node.js process. So with the help of key metrics, we can monitor on the particular instance or particular PM2 process, which will give us the statics about the Node.js app, the logs, the statics, the memory, the CPU consumption and all. So I already signed up, so I will just subscribe it for free and bare minimum. Bucket name is like test bucket I'm putting. So test bucket is available for 4 processes. Continue. So key matrix is, just read about it, what key matrix is doing. It is another tool like New Relic to check the statics of your application. So what I need to do now, I will install the PM2, install -z PM2 is already there. So I will just link my current running PM2 process with the help of this command. Right, so link public private key mechanism has been added, PM2 is activated here. So you can see I will start getting the instance, getting the application statics from there, right? You can see my MacBook, that application name API server app now started giving the data to this application. Now you can just get more information like this kind of statics you will get whenever you purchase the premium subscription of it. But this is like this is one of the coolest thing that it is giving you at least more information about your particular process. What else I can show you? It will provide you the dashboard that how much memory that particular process is consuming, what is the loop delay, and all these things, all the statics you will be able to capture. So this is one of the nice tool for monitoring the PM2 processes. I think the logs and all you will not be able to see, but I can see the app instances, right? API server app was there. Now I'm able to see that. And how I did it, I just executed this link command, which will link your system to this particular key matrix account, and you'll start getting the monitoring statics from your system to this particular application. Okay, so it is just doing a public private key communications, and you are able to seed the data from your application. So you can in the same way you can actually monitor your production application. So in the production application, what you need to do, you configure this key matrix. You don't need to write anything, you just create account and just execute the simple command. It will enable the key matrix configuration for this particular prop bucket, and you will be able to see the data there. Okay, other thing is I think what is that key matrix configuration. Yeah, so how to configure the key matrix. Key matrix is the one of the good tool to monitor your particular processes in the application. So it is giving you the complete statics about the status, the incoming data, process management, all the versioning. You can also do the remote restart of the PM2 process, and you can see all the complete logs from here. So what PM2 is providing, PM2 is providing a whole lot of features. You can track down the log, you can do the application overview, you can see the exception pages where you can see which particular API or which particular is giving the exception. You can see the CPU graph. You can just take the memory snapshot visualization. If you're buying it as a premium, then you are going to get all these different features, transaction monitoring, or so all these things are being provided by the PM2 Plus or Key Matrix. Key Matrix is providing its different plans. I just shown you the demo for the free plan, where I'm just getting the PM2 instance information, and I'm not getting much information. I'm just seeing the PM2 statics and few information regarding that. So it is easy to get started. I hope you will like it if you started using it. Thanks everyone.